In the 11th session of machine learning, we will discuss the XGBoost, called extreme gradient boosting. This video is part one of a series on XGBoost. Let's look at the training and the prediction process of XGBoost regression. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice was generated through AI, text-to-speech. Let's take a look at the full table of contents. Chapter 1 provides an overview of XGBoost. In chapters 2 and 3, we will look at the exact greedy algorithm. In chapter 2, we will look at the regression, and in chapter 3, we will look at the classification. The exact greedy algorithm is very accurate, but takes a long time when there is a lot of data. In chapter 4, we will look at the split finding algorithm. For large amounts of data, the exact greedy algorithm takes a long time, so an approximate method is needed. Let's take a look at the weighted quantile sketch method, and also look at parallel processing methods. In chapter 5, we will look at how to use the XGBoost library. In this video, we will look at the training and the prediction process of XGBoost regression. XGBoost is an ensemble learning method proposed by Tianqi Chen and Carlos Gestrin in 2016. This is an improved version of the existing GBM algorithm to effectively process large amounts of data. XGBoost applies the regularization and the pruning to create decision trees, and the methods to roughly determine the optimal split points to effectively process large amounts of data were presented. Additionally, various techniques were presented, including missing value handling, parallel processing, and cache-aware access, etc. The title of this paper is A Scalable Tree Boosting System. A key consideration is how to create scalable trees to handle the large amounts of data. The main contents of this paper are as follows. There is quite a lot of content. The first part covers ensemble boosting algorithms, and the second covers techniques closer to computer science than machine learning. In this video, we will look at the first part related to the ensemble boosting algorithm. For XGBoost regression, let's look at how to find the best split points using the exact greedy algorithm. Let's first look at the training process. Similar to the CART algorithm in decision trees, the exact greedy algorithm examines all split point candidates and finds the best split point among them. So we can find the best split points with great accuracy. However, if there is a lot of data, it will take a long time. Since the GBM uses regular decision trees, it uses the gain calculated by the Gini index or entropy to find the best split points. However, XGBoost uses the gain calculated from the similarity scores to find the best split points. The exact greedy algorithm splits a node using all split point candidates and selects the best split among them. Let's take a look at the training process through a simple example. The source of below example is the XGBoost Part 1 of YouTube StatQuest. Let's look at the example below. This data has one feature X and one target Y. And the number of data points is 4, which is very simple. The target Y values are all real numbers, so this is a regression problem. Step 1 calculates the initial prediction of target Y and uses this initial prediction to calculate the residuals. We can use a random value as the initial prediction, or use the average value of target Y. In this example, 0.5 was used as the initial prediction. This estimate is updated during each iteration, so it is not very sensitive to the initial prediction. The initial predictions for all data points are set to 0.5 like this. We then calculate the residuals using the actual Y values and the initial predictions. For the first data point, the actual Y value is -10, and the initial prediction is 0.5, so the residual is -10.5. In this way, we calculate the residuals for all data points. Now, like GBM, we construct a root node with these residuals and create a decision tree. Step 2 calculates the similarity score for this root node. The formula for calculating the score is as follows. The numerator is the square of the sum of the residuals. This notation is the number of residuals belonging to this node. And the lambda is a regularization constant and a hyperparameter. The number of residuals in the root node is 4, and the lambda is set to 1. Therefore, the similarity score of this root node is 3.2. The reason for calculating the score like this will be discussed in detail in the next video as we analyze the contents of the paper. In step 3, all split point candidates of feature X are used to split the root node into child nodes. We then calculate the similarity scores for each child node. Similar to the CART algorithm, all split point candidates between data points must be used. This is the exact greedy algorithm. Let's just think about the two split points here, A and B. The split point A is 17, which is the median between 12 and 22. The point A splits the root node into left and right nodes. The first data point belongs to the left node, and the remaining three data points belong to the right node. With the split point B, two pieces of data are split into left and right sides respectively. Tree B is then split as follows. Next, for each leaf node, we calculate the similarity score using the formula above. For the first leaf node in tree A, the number of residuals is 1 and the lambda is 1. So the similarity score is 55.13. For the second leaf node, the number of residuals is 3 and the lambda is 1, so the similarity score is 10.56. If we calculate the scores in the same way for tree B, we get these results. The larger the sum of the scores of child nodes, the more likely it is that this split is optimal. In the example below, tree A is better than tree B. If a leaf node contains many residuals with different signs, the similarity score will be smaller. That is because they cancel each other out. For the second leaf node in the tree A, these two values cancel each other out because they have different signs. Then the numerator gets smaller and the score gets smaller as well. Decreasing the similarity score is similar to increasing entropy in CART. Conversely, more residuals of the same sign result in a higher similarity score. And the smaller the number of residuals in a leaf node, the smaller the score. This is because the influence of the lambda increases. When there are three residuals, the impact of lambda 1 is relatively small. But when there is only one residual, the impact of lambda 1 is larger. In step 4, the gain is calculated using the similarity scores before and after the node splitting. The formula for calculating the gain is as follows. The difference between the sum of the scores before and after the node is split. and the gamma is pruning constant and a hyperparameter. For tree A on the previous page, the root node has a similarity score of 3.2. After splitting, the scores of each child node are 55.13 and 10.56. So the gain is calculated like this. Here the gamma is set to 10. So tree A gets a gain of 52.49. If we calculate the gain of tree B in the same way, we get -7.87. Since the gain of tree A is greater than that of tree B, tree B is discarded and tree A is chosen. This is a better split. In this way, the tree with the highest gain is selected among all split candidates. However, if the gain is less than zero, this node will not be split. This is because there is no benefit from the split. For example, if tree A has a gain of -5.0, this value is also greater than the gain of tree B. However, since this is less than zero, we will not split this node. The gamma controls whether the node is split or not, splitting or pruning. The larger the gamma, the less likely it is that a node will split. So the gamma acts as a pruner. Let us assume that the tree A is the final choice in the first iteration round, because it has the highest gain and the gain is greater than zero. In step 5, we continue to split the tree A. This time we will split it using the points C and D. Then, as we did before, we calculate the similarity scores for each leaf node and use them to calculate the gain. The score before the node splitting is 10.56. Then the gain of this split in tree C is 72.9. For tree D, the gain of this split is 0.57. Since the gain of tree C is greater than that of D and greater than zero, tree C is selected as the final tree in the second round. Step 6 calculates the output values for each leaf node in the final tree. The output value is calculated using this formula. For GBM regression, the output value was calculated as the average of the residuals. In XGBoost, the lambda is added to the denominator term. This is a regularization constant. We will also look at this formula in more detail in the next video. Here J is the leaf node number, and I is the data point number belonging to this leaf node. In the paper, the output value is denoted as W, so W is used here as well. When we iterated twice on the previous page, the final tree would look like this. This tree has 3 leaf nodes. Calculating the output values of each leaf node using the above formula are as follows. Here the lambda is set to 1. In step 7, the new predictions, y-hat, are calculated using the output values. This is how the new prediction is calculated. The initial prediction and the output values are used. Here, eta is the learning rate, and j is the leaf node number to which this data point belongs. And w is the output value. The first data point belongs to the first leaf node. Therefore, the output value of the first data point is -5.25. The initial prediction value was 0.5, and the learning rate was set to 0.3. Then the output value is -5.25. Therefore, the new prediction, y hat, for the first data point is minus 1.08. In this way, we compute the new predictions for every data point. Since both the second and third data points belong to the same leaf node, their output values are the same, 4.67. Step 8 computes new residuals using the new predictions. For the first data point, the actual y value was negative 10, but the new prediction is minus 0.8. Therefore, the new residual is negative 8.92. In this way, we calculate the new residuals for all the data points. We then see that the new residuals are smaller than the residuals from the previous iteration. As the iteration progresses, the residuals become smaller and smaller, and the new predictions are becoming more and more accurate. Step 9 creates a new tree using the new residuals. And we repeat this process over and over again. Then the residuals will continue to decrease, and the predicted y hat will closer and closer to the actual y. Next, let's look at the prediction process. I would like to predict the target value for the test data below. The target value for this test data can be predicted using the trees generated during the training process. This is identical to the GBM process. Let's say the tree created in the first iteration looks like this. And the tree created in the second iteration looks like this. This tree was generated by these residuals. In the final step, these two trees are used to predict the target value for the test data. The target value of the test data is calculated like this. Y0 is the initial prediction of the training data. And the tree's output values are used when inputting the test data. Since the feature X is 18, this test data point belongs to the second leaf node in this tree. The output value is 4.67. Since it also belongs to the second leaf node in the second tree, the output value is 3.73. If the learning rate is 0.3, the target value for this test data point is predicted to be 3.02. In this example, we used only two trees in two iterations to simplify the problem. In actual training, multiple trees are created by increasing the number of iterations until the residuals are sufficiently reduced. And in this example, even though the split points on both trees were the same, they will actually be different. So far, we have looked at the training and the prediction process for XGBoost Regression's exact greedy algorithm. In the next video, we will analyze this algorithm in more detail through the contents of the paper.